Madam.
From this only difference in ladies and gentlemen provide this curtain in gen side and in ladies side it is under two.
Medium.
Things are changing now.
It's very modern, very high technology.
Even today's, even today's, even today's, sent it to the people. Just the
Thank you. There's no need to expose yourself or have the privacy that you wish for. keep it clean, that's the only deal. Use the bathroom as a meal. Use the bathroom as a meal. Excuse me, sir. 10 minutes.
Now I'm at peace. Now we're in the ease. Making people smile.
Hats off to such a benevolent mission.
Don't go for open vacation. Are you getting fiction?
Take toilets for granted, failing to realize how indispensable toilets actually are. In the morning, when we don't get our newspaper or bread or milk on time, we get so restless. Imagine the plight of an individual who doesn't get access to a toilet in the morning, especially when he needs it the most. Have a look.
Finish up quick, bro.
Okay. I'll come fast, pal.
Go faster. Hey, come out!
I'm going. I'll be back soon.
How many times we tried to come early, but we found him before.
Come out, yaar.
I mean, I'm also saying get out, but it's not getting out.
Once it comes out, I also come out.
Bro.
I want to do something. Kick and bust his stomach. You don't understand the problem, people.
Hey, have you slept?
He slept?
Arey, wake him up. He really slept, jitna.
No, bro. silly. Go, man. Why are you creating a mess and disturbing me by shouting and crying? I mean, let me sit here for 2 minutes peacefully at least.
Get me that pillow to you.
And bedsheet too.
Send him pillow and bedsheet so that he could make bed and sleep there.
Can't you come fast?
Why?
Yes, why have you been banging on the door? I've not gone to sleep in there.
Hey, can't you see the crowd, eh?
I have to go. What do I mean by...
Hey, open the gate.
How is it going? Hey, do you come out?
What do I care?
Open. Hey, open.
Foreigners have always been very apprehensive about the availability of public toilets in India. And to a large extent, justifiably so. Tiring efforts for the past 5 decades, the government now is also striving to make
it.
I can't touch this. I can't. I don't know.
Well, what kind of problem is this?
Now what to do with this man? Look, Mukherjee. There goes Mangaru. Call him. He can clean it up with his mop only.
And how will he clean it with brush?
Then what else do you think you can do now?
Okay, then call that Mangaru.
Hello, Mangaru. Mangaru, come here. Come fast, come fast.
Not like that. Now in the village, in every house has Sulabh toilets. Everywhere is happiness. Go and sit relaxably.
Really?
Yes.
Really?
Go.
Where is it?
This one. And
wow, nice. What to say?
Friends, today we're not going to talk about someone from some bygone era. No. He is a contemporary, selfless, ingenious sage. He is not to renounce the world, nor does he live as a recluse. He lives amongst us, but he lives amongst us as a hermit. In fact, I call him a hermit with a difference. When ends were hard to meet, when hunger was hard to beat, the hermit with a difference realized that aside from food, our stomach had another very imperative need. And guess what, Jim? Yes. We are talking about toilets. Just think about it. We can withstand hunger for some time, but when pressure in the bowels builds up, we have no choice. We just have to run. You can well imagine that the very first person in this world to realize this very important human need must have been a very great vision. Let's turn the clock back to 1968, when not only in our villages, but in many homes of our great cities, there were no toilets. At markets, bus stands, railway stations, fairs and holy places, the situation became even more desperate. When the call of nature came a-calling, people had no choice but to defecate in open fields. In such a scenario, a prodigious scholar of the social sciences foresaw the urgent need of providing toilets in public places, in villages, cities, and towns alike. This hermit with a difference took up this work as his mission, and since then has given his entire life, each and every moment of it, to this mission. In the Hindi language, Sulabh means readily available, and hence this work, this mission was christened Sulabh Toilet. Once ostracized by his own brethren, today this visionary is revered around the globe. We know this transcendental, virtuous hermit as Dr. Bindeshwar Patil. His mission of making toilets at public places has now transcended into making toilets in schools, villages, towns, and even residences in cities. And along this untiring journey in the quest of public cleanliness, Dr. Patil has successfully undertaken the pious task of liberating millions of women from the filthy tradition of having to carry night soil on their heads. No procession, nor any slogan. Neither war, nor any attrition. Without any desire for grants or donation, he pursues his goal of a pure nation. He took up this tough challenge with steely determination. He realized Gandhiji's dream of a clean and healthy nation. It is such a pleasant coincidence that this mission is in line with the vision of another benefactor of cleanliness, our Honorable Prime Minister, Sri Narendra Modi. The doyen of cleanliness, harmony and divinity, Dr. Bindeshwar Patil, and his never-ending, unceasing efforts have been encapsulated in this melodious song. Let us look, listen, and behold. And by the way, there have been many times when I have also used Sulabh toilets.
Come to visit this campus. We extend our hearty and warm welcome to all of you here in this prayer hall. We have a very important guest among us. We have today Hon'ble Madam Piyawan Gongsakdi. She is the wife of His Excellency, the Ambassador of Thailand to India, Hon'ble Mr. Chettida Kitchaiwat. And Madam Piyawan, she is also a teacher in Thailand. So we want to welcome you, ma'am, with our Sulabh traditional way of welcoming the guests with a shawl and a garland.
Very close relationship, cultural relationship. and relation language, historical experience, common history, historical features. We all know each other, but the point is that still we are separated by common language, common history. So we are especially very happy that they are women. They are sensitive to the problem. When men come, they talk of politics. They come up with constituencies. When the women come, they think who is the last person. Now that you have come, you will see, you know what the picture, how we serve the last person. We are not talking politics. We are not. We have plenty of things. Till then, it's a land of free. People have always been free. The only country in the peninsula which has been free, though it has been considerable influence, they have the common conqueror, French, Dutch, Portuguese. They all have conquered Finland, but Thailand. But still, they have also conquered all countries. We have shared war in the Second World War. The Second World War. We have a common history. We have a common Rama Saranshan cultural heritage. Ramayana is read in Thailand with as much devotion and respect. Many of our languages have, words of the languages have gone to Thailand. Many of the Thai language and cultural language. But still, we have been not knowing it yet. Not knowing because we are a conquered country. Fighting war for others, fighting everything. We have common historical background. Let us sit and share and think about it. The honorable guests, we have asked you, invited you specially to see what we are doing. Sulabh movement is the largest social movement in the country. And Dr. Bindeshwar Patel is the tallest social reformer of our times. She has led this movement for 50 years, changing society, changing what people think, to change a new society. He has sought to shift the mountain without raising that. He has been trying it for many times. Look at this. That is a very disadvantage. So how do you help him? This man, for 50 years, from difficult time, very difficult time, without power, without money, has been working to promote and bring this man, this advantage person, in the social ministry. You know all this. This social movement has also been taken in Thailand. Your movement, social movement, has also revolted against authoritarian government. We have common experience. We know how suffered together. We have suffered this advantage together. I welcome you on behalf of the civil officer of international. It's a very special person. Very special people who will promote together the common concern for the poor. People who cannot speak for themselves. The poor. The uneducated. We will speak. Beauty speaker, I join you. So you join me together. That is Mr. Father. So one thing is here. If at all any social change has to be made, it will be made not by the government, but by the people. You have made it by the people. In your country. There has been a continuous growth of the people in the Kenyan society. And now, Bangkok is the leading country of the world. Thailand is a rising economy, prosperous people, good and handsome people who are working, who are touring all over the world to plead cause for us. I welcome you again, Delhi.
Hon'ble Madam Piyawan Gongsakdi, poet of His Excellency, the Ambassador of Thailand to India, Hon'ble Madam Piyawan Gongsakdi. Maybe something is taken as spelling. Wife of Minister and Deputy Chief of Mission, Royal Thai Embassy in New Delhi, Old Madam Chettida Kitchaiwat, Official Comrade Thai Embassy in New Delhi, Friends of Sulabh. We feel proud and privileged welcoming all the guests in this Sulabh campus. Yesterday, in an award ceremony, the organizers of the seminar, of the award ceremony, said Sulabh is one of the five dhams. Shankaracharya is made four and Sulabh is fifth. We are very happy. We have solved the problems of sanitation in India, and these technologies are quite for global application. 2.4 billion people have no access to safe and hygiene toilets. And we have kept these technologies free from patents. Anyone can do in all country. So this is very important that 90% people, they talk about the problems of the society, but here we talk about how to solve the problems of the society. Talking problems will not help. Apart from sanitation, also we have helped the untouchables who is to clean human feces, and they did good things for society, but they were called untouchables. Indians will touch dogs, but not human beings. So we have transformed their lives, what Gandhi wanted. And those who are sitting in the yellow dress, they are the persons. They see the age of those. Some of them not married even today. But now they have become Brahmins. This is a revolution we have brought to this country. That in India, people used to be known by earlier Vedic period, whatever the works you do, you will consider of a certain caste. Then came by birth. If I am a Brahmin, my son will be a Brahmin, irrespective of whether he is a learned person or not. He has not proper education, but because he is my son, so he will be a Brahmin. Now we have changed this, and we say no. Now we can opt your caste as per choice. Indians are free to choose religions. They can choose Christianity, they can choose Islam or Buddhism. So we say you can change your caste in the Hindu religion. So these are some things we have done. It's a long history of Sulabh, 50 years. So I will not take too much time. We provide some literature to you. You can see we have transformed the lives of the widows in this country. We have done many experiments in this country about the technology, a social reform, and so on and so forth. So be these words. Once again, we welcome you in the campus on behalf of Sulabh campus. So this is Hindi, English. So you can understand properly.
Guest Madam Piyawan Gongsakdi to kindly address the gathering and share her valuable thoughts with us, and also a word of blessings to all of us.
Thank you, everyone. It's my great pleasure to be here today. And as you know, our princess, Mementos in Thailand, has already been here for 2 times. So, and it is at Sulabh, is one of her favorite places in India. So, I think I have to come and see it myself. And today I have a good opportunity to come and see what Dr. Videshwar has done to the community and to India and even for the world. I have seen the public toilet, the water ATM, the biogas, the school, the museum, and also the evolution of toilets. And I would like to thank you very much for your warm welcome from Dr. Bindeshwa and all the staff members. And in about a few weeks time, I will bring my friend, ladies from 10 ASEAN countries to visit here also. I hope to see you all again, and today I would like to thank you very much.
Now I request Dr. Lalit Kumar, Senior Vice President in this organization, to kindly deliver a vote of thanks.
I am honored and humbled to present formal vote of thanks to our very important guests today. Hon'ble Madam Piyawan Gongsakdi, Hon'ble Madam Waraporn Sugondhabhirom, and Hon'ble Madam Chettida Kitchaiwat. S.P. Singh ji, our sisters from Tonk, Rajasthan. After releasing them from this inhuman practice of carrying humans actually on their heads, Dr. Bhattak has set up 3 vocational training centers at Alwar, Tonk, and Ghaziabad. And our sisters have come from Tonk, Rajasthan. My colleagues from both families. I'm really overwhelmed. I was with them during the tour, and Madam Piyawan was asking questions at every place, right from our health center till end. So we are really grateful to the team guests, all 3, and Queen B and Princess C. That's our common name. Her pet name is B, so she is Queen B. And her name is C. So we are really grateful for the pleasant tour. And Madam Piyawan's personality is so pleasing and affable. Our students, they didn't want to leave you. Till the end, you were leaving, they were waving you. So we look forward for your next visit. And thank you so much for coming here and spending your valuable time with us. Thank you very much.
पंजाब सिंध गुजरात मराठा द्रविड़ उत्कल वंदा विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उच्छल जल तरंगा तब शुभ नामे जागे तब शुभ आशीष मांगे गाए तब जय गाथा जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत। Jaya Hai, Jaya Hai, Jaya Hai, Jaya, 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 Jaya Hai.
Thank you.
Thank you, Bajita.
Photograph. Toyota.